Hello everybody, welcome back to the ESC Scot YouTube channel, another ESC Scot YouTube video. So, we have got all 37 of this year's Eurovision entries, which it's gone really quick. Put in the comments, I think it's gone really, like, extremely quick. I remember getting Ukraine's Twitch, I remember getting that from VidBear, and I felt like it was yesterday. Like, it really has gone extremely quick. I'm so excited. Like, I am actually really excited. I've just booked my flights for Liverpool. So it's all getting kind of real. It's really real. One video I wanted to do this year, I knew I wanted to do it because Eurovision, the official YouTube channel, always puts like a recap of all of the performances. I know I've done individual reactions of all the songs, but some of them I've not watched and not reminded myself of them in quite a while. So what I wanted to do was kind of just do a reaction to the recap of all 37 of the entries. Some of them have got revamped, but what I'm planning on doing is reviewing and reacting to the revamps later this week in full. But yeah, the good thing about this recap is the snippets of the songs are actually longer than what you would find on like YouTube channels that upload recaps. So this is great, this is exciting. I get to hear some of the revamps because I've not listened to Ukraine's revamp, Albania's revamp, or Ireland's. Not heard many good things about Ireland's, but hey ho, we'll move on. Okay, so I think they go in alphabetical order, so first up will be about Albania. So let's do it. Right, let's press play and remind ourselves of all these amazing entries. First up, Albania. This grown on me so much. It was near the bottom of my list, of my top, of my Eurovision scoreboard. And it's now near the top. It's like top 12, I think it's 11th or something like that. And this is the revamp. So it's a bit more upbeat. It's not as dreary. I think that's one thing that made it a bit, you know. Yeah, it's got an extra beat in there. Yeah, that's definitely better. Armenia, Brunette, Future Lover. A lot of people have been disappointed by this. I think they were expecting a pop song, like just a bop, really. I think people were expecting that from Brunette, and they didn't get that, and then they just went in a strop. I enjoy it. I don't think it's a Eurovision winner, but I think it's good enough to get top 10. But she needs a really good performance on stage. Australia, I like this. I like this as well. Oh, this is the kind of stuff that me and my dad listen to though, so I knew I'd love this. I need to listen to this again because from this snippet it's really good. Oh, yeah, I do love this song actually. I need to listen to it again, I've not listened to Australia in a while. There's a ghost in the bar. Oh, come on. I'd be so happy if this won, by the way. This is my third now. I never thought I'd say that. Come on. Vienna 2024, here we come. I think this is going to be an absolute iconic song on stage. They need to nail the staging. If they do, then... Oh! It's a ghost in my body. Ah, I can't do it. Who the hell is Edgar? Azerbaijan. Not the biggest fan of this song, to be fair. I have listened to it a few times after my reaction of it. It's okay. It's not... I expected more from Azerbaijan, really. It's not a bad song, though. It isn't. It's sweet. Belgium, Gustav. The world got me going crazy. It was so weird how everyone went, no, when he won Eurosong. I didn't watch Eurosong, so I didn't really know the reaction or anything. I just seen it on Twitter. But it's weird how everyone's reaction went from no to yes to this, like within a month. Like, people love this now. It's in my top 10, so I'll okay. I have got this last in my top 37. I think I might need to change it. I just don't think it's not a Eurovision song. I don't think it's just not. Juries will hate this, I think. Obviously, if it gets to the final, that's the only time it will get a judgment from a jury, but I don't think this will qualify. Weird, I don't know. I really don't know. Wait a minute, I need to elaborate on that. Croatia is so out there, and it's such a strong message that it actually might be that weird enough, or it might be just that. Eurovision is all about weirdness. I think everyone relates Eurovision quite weird, crazy, batshit crazy stuff. And that is that. Like that music video, oh my god, could you get any more weird than that? No. In Dora, they didn't really it wasn't a great live performance. Like, his vocals were good, but it just was all over the place. There was too much going on stage that I just couldn't keep up. If they change the staging slightly, because they'll have to for Eurovision, they will not be able to do what they've done in their national final on Liverpool stage. They won't be able to do that. They'll have to change it. So, I don't know. It's literally, if they can nail the staging, make his vocals slightly better, and change the staging, I think they might qualify, possibly. But we'll move on. Cyprus, Chypre. I like this, but there's so many songs similar to this in this year, and I'll say the same for the other song that's like it. His vocals are really good. I saw a clip of him on Instagram doing that high note, and he can do it. This is weird how people loved this in the first week it like got announced that they would represent Czechia, and then where is the hype gone? It's like literally just dissipated. I think this is going to be one to watch. I think this might be quite an underdog, because it's not a favourite to win, really, is it? No, it's not. I think if it comes to the Eurovision stage and blows people away, like it did when we first heard it, people got emotional over this song. It's just so amazing. Okay, Denmark, Riley. Now, if he wasn't as famous as he is online, I don't think this would qualify. But because it's 100% televote and he's got 10 million TikTok followers, I think he's gonna qualify. Yeah, I think he will. It is a catchy song, but it's just we've heard a million of these types of songs, do you know what I mean? I like it, but there's nothing special about it. Time to go back and try. Oh. I do love this song actually, I think it's in my fifth place. This song, when I first listened to it, it really connected to me, so that's why I have it so high. Love this song. Cannot wait to see it live, to be fair. Cannot wait. Oh, bridges. Oh, come on. She's got such a good voice live, she can belt. Come on. Karia. This may win. This may win. If the juries don't screw him over, he'll win. I think he's the biggest competitor. Him and Norway are the biggest competitor for Loreen this year. Yeah. I hope the juries don't screw him over, because I think me and along with everyone else is just worried about that. There's two types of people with this song. They either love it or it's at the bottom of their leaderboard. Evidemment. Hype for this has kind of gone down a bit as well. I don't think it's a Eurovision winner, but top 10 is possible. See if she does what she does in the music video on stage, she'll do fine. Do not do anything too crazy about this. All she needs is that staging. All she needs to do is take whatever she done there and put it on the stage, and she'll be fine. I love the ending to If You Do Not. Georgia! Okay. This is good. This is Georgia's best entry in God knows how long. Yeah. The only problem with this, and it's not just me, because I've seen loads of comments about it, I can't understand what she's saying 90% of the time. And I know it's not really about that, like, you can't understand that, but it's like she's mumbling almost. Glöre, sweet. Germany's best song in a while as well. I thought The Lord of the Lost is the best chance for Germany to crack the top 10, I think. Go. It was the best out of their selection that they had. We are blood and glitter. Oh. Yes. Okay, Greece. It is good, but I just don't know about it. I need to see the staging for this. I'm excited to see the staging for this, because this could really elevate the song a lot. And he's got a good voice live, he's one of the best vocalists this year, and he's only 16 years old. He doesn't sound like a 16-year-old at all, though. That voice is amazing. Iceland. She's got a good voice. She can belt. I'm not sure about the song yet. I've not listened to it enough, I need to listen to it a bit more. Oh, okay. There's just something about it, I don't feel like it's as powerful as a lot of others, but I still like it. Oh, is this the revamp? Oh, it is? Oh, there is something different in there. I don't know if it sounds as good though. What is that extra element they've added? Is it extra drums? I think so. It is different. I've seen a lot of people saying that it's the same, it's not. Oh! I don't know, you know. I'll need to react to that fully. Unica! Oh, God! This is great. I've underestimated this a lot because I listened to this morning. I was like, oh my god, this is really good. I need to put this higher. It does feel like there is five genres just smooshed into 3 minutes. It does feel like that's not necessarily good. That dance break then is going to be feminine. Oh, come on. I mean, it's such a sweet song. It is, it really is so sweet. Such a great tune. But we've heard millions of these kinds of songs. It's just, I think this could be a slight underdog though. On the Eurovision stage, juries will just kind of eat this up, I think. This is actually nearer the bottom for me as well. I'm just not the biggest fan of this kind of type of song. I remember people came for me in the comments and my reaction to this, because they said it was generic, and I'm like, and they're trying to fight saying, this is not generic, there's just no other song like this in Eurovision this year. Yeah, there might not be songs like this in Eurovision this year, but I do think this is slightly generic. Like, it's the lyrics, if you were to read the lyrics without the music, just read them. But like, I've heard millions of these. This is good. Do you like Lithuania? Do you like Monica? Malta. This is interesting. I think this might open. Ireland or Malta will open the semi-final one. Go watch my running order predictions, I've done that earlier. This is great. I've not seen the music video, it's really good. I don't know how impactful it'd be on a Eurovision stage though. I don't know. Okay, Moldova. This is good. This is good. I listened to this last night again, and like, it does have something about it, and that staging at the national final was really good, but they have to just elevate it a bit more and this will be amazing on stage. It kind of gives off France last year, the vibes of that, and obviously that didn't do too great, but I think this will definitely qualify. Netherlands. I'm scared for this actually now, because it's in a really hard semi-final. I'm thinking this will seriously struggle, especially with 100% telly. I know it is liked, but it's, I don't know if it's liked enough. Come on. I mean, Norway's my first, Norway is my winner. She's just like, oh, come on. I want her to win so bad. I just want her to win so bad. I mean, I know people think this song is quite generic and stuff, but that whistle note at the end, just, it impressed me so much, and the song really is what Eurovision's about to me. We've not seen a song win like this in ages. Oh, Alessandra, if she'd done what she'd done in the final performance at MGP, she's definitely top three. Definitely top three. The juries will love that. The juries will love it more than televoters, I think. If she does well in both them, then she has a chance to win. And I'm just, oh, I hope she wins. I really hope she wins. Poland, obviously. A lot of drama around this. I love this song. Down, baby, down. Obviously, there's just a lot of drama around this. It's nothing to do with her. I know you kind of say it is. But it's to do with the broadcaster. The broadcaster, you shouldn't be giving her hate, really. Portugal. I do like this. But yeah, I think this is another one that may struggle to qualify. I'm sure it's in semi-final one. I caught a Yeah, Derek Ethnic gives me the kind of vibes. It's going to be great on the Eurovision stage. I just can't wait to see all these live. I just can't wait. Such a performer as well. This guy's getting so much hate for no reason as well. Especially in his own country. He's got a great voice. The song, I think it needs a revamp. I think it really does. I don't know if it's too late now, but yeah. I like it. Oh, this is one that's kind of just been shoved into the shadows, isn't it? San Marino. I mean, it's not a bad song. Like, it isn't, but it isn't strong though, is it? Out of all the entries that submitted a song to San Marino's national final, this was the best. I doubt it. I didn't watch San Marino's national final, so I don't know. Serbia. Game over. This is just so unique, and it will stand out massively. Instruments are great. It's just so out the box, and remember, as I say, Eurovision's all about that weirdness, all about that cookie music, I always say. The lyrics are really weird to me, but they are good. Oh, come on. This, to me, this year, is the biggest underdog. If Slovenia pulls out a really amazing performance and really blows people away, and they're big, they are quite big in Slovenia and neighbouring countries, I think. Instrumentals are great, his voice is good as well. This performance, as I say, I've always said that about this song, I will never ever download this and just stream it endlessly. It's not one of the kind of songs. Like, listening to it now, it's just like, okay, it's fine. But the performance is what makes her so good. Her movements, her voice, her kind of style, it's just, it's all a package. And it's an amazing package. Queen, mother, she's so good. She's just, I really don't want her to win a landslide. It's more likely she is going to win. I would love to go back to Sweden. It's an amazing country. I hope that the voting, I've seen a lot of people saying the voting is going to be boring. Personally, it might be. I hope it's not though. I really hope it's not. I hope there is a big challenger to her. So do. I don't wanna have to say you. This is kind of being shoved into the shadows as well. I feel bad for it a wee bit. Because it's a good song. The voice is really good as well. I've not seen this one live yet though. I'm actually really interested in seeing one song live, for it's coming up. I'm really excited to see it live. Don't care what you say, yeah, yeah. I've not seen the revamp of this yet. Is this it? There's nothing different. I'll listen to the revamp later. This is definitely underrated right now by the fandom. I enjoy it. Won't win probably, but I'd love it to finish top 10. So, yeah, like the British rap and replace it with like a dance break or something. Even though she's not a trained dancer, like I don't think she actually can dance confidently. You can always get trained, can't you? But I'd love that. Well, that is it. All of the 37 songs competing in Eurovision this year. What I'm going to do in the coming days is going to rank my semi-finals. So I'm going to go from 1 to 15, 1 to 16. And also I'm going to do my running order prediction of semi-final 2 coming up in a few days as well. I'm not going to tell you my favourites out of them yet, because I'm going to listen to them all again over the next few days. I'm going to have a really good Eurovision playlist on Spotify, play them all at least twice, and kind of change about my top 37, because I have a top 37 right now of my first initial reaction, that's up on the channel right now, I'll link it below. But I'm going to kind of listen to them again, and then I'll come back in about a week's time and rank all of the 37 songs from 1 to 37. I think I know my winner. I don't think Norway's going to budge. I think Norway's just the standout for me this year. I don't know why, I think it's just on first listen, I've not stopped listening to it, and it's my favourite. Does that make me plain and boring? Probably, but I don't give a shit. And that's it. That is my reaction to all the 37 songs. Like the video and subscribe to the channel for more Eurovision videos. As I say, I've literally just booked flights to Liverpool. I'm really excited. Tell me if you're going down below in the comments, and also contact me on Instagram if you're going. Tell me. And as I say, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.